Welcome back to the channel. Today we're doing some WWE 2K23, and we're looking at some of the live events. We're looking at the Island versus the Dungeon, which was, four, events that you needed specific cards for to get four more cards, which you use for the final event, Decisive Battle, for the Solo Sikoa, which is an awesome looking card. So what we're going to do is we're going to actually watch. We're actually going to do all the fights. So in this event. So a total of five fights. Last one is a really good final fight with an 8-man elimination tag. So it's against a pink diamond. So it's a pretty brutal little run. So anyway, let's get started. Welcome back to the channel. Tonight we're doing some WWE 2K23. What we're doing is we're working on the live events that released today. And this one is going to be the Island versus the Dungeon Part 1 of 4. It's going to use a Sapphire Tamina from the Phenomenal Pack. And it's going to, we're working for the Yokozuna live event rewards. Now, as you can see, there's Part 2. And that one is going to be coming out in a couple of days. Well, 3 days, I guess. 2.5 days. And it's got the Solo Sikoa card you use for an Umaga, I don't know, for the Sapphire card. And then in roughly 6 days, we're looking at the Island versus the Dungeon Part 3 of 4 for Rikishi Sapphire using Jimmy Uso. And then on Glover Week, we're looking at Part 4, which is going to be using a Jey Uso card from the Danger Zone packs to get a Sapphire Roman Reigns. And then it all closes out with this Decisive Battle, which seems a bit long into the future, but around 20 more days, you'll use all four of the cards that we received from this to go for an Amethyst Solo Sikoa, which looks like a really good card. But anyway, what we're going to do today is we're going to go ahead and start the one that we have, because it's only out there for about 5 days, and we're going to update our lineup to the Tamika, wherever she is. There, she's a 76. It's the first time I've actually used this card, so we will take a quick look at the moves and all that when we get into it. So it's against a pink diamond Natalya.
And kicking things off is Natalya, the true
96 rating. We gotta get 9 MSP, which is kind of a pain.
Especially that old school style.
Her moves are kind of slow, to be honest. I do like the fact she has to like the
MP. At this point, her legend seems almost on par with her famous uncle.
I just want to stop it for a second and look at the moves. So her finisher is a dive, which I'm not a big fan of. And we got grab attacks, torso.
What's his name?
Natalya's proven herself to be a true mentor and a measuring stick in the locker room. And she shows no signs of slowing down.
And then there's Tamina. You know, a popular song once said, "I'm only happy when it rains." Well, Tamina's only happy when there's pain. Pain that she's inflicting upon her opponents.
That is definitely Tamina's MO, Corey. Nobody, Mina, then Tamina.
That should be some grab attacks, so we're going to check them here. Yep.
And she makes that clear with everything she does.
The powerhouse Tamina, as mean and tough as they come.
She does stun quickly, I have to say.
The obvious answer is to pick up the pace. We all know Tamina likes things slow and steady, and speed definitely isn't her wheelhouse. So you just have to use that against her.
All right.
She returns the favor there.
Tamina showing how much punishment she can withstand before dishing it back tenfold.
Tamina hoping to start a rush of her own with that attack.
Goodness gracious.
And if the first up doesn't send you the message, the follow-up ones definitely will.
Just a barrage of stomps.
gonna check the match action one more time. So I am comboing
heavy attacks,
and it's actually not counting which is kind of bad, because those really should count. In games that really count those a lot of times. But you can do grab damage. I think we should have three there.
Nothing wrong there, just dictating the pace. Down the windpipe. Things not going how she'd like. Well, all things considered, Cole, it's not a bad condition to be in at this point in the match.
Goodness gracious.
A non-stop assault from Tamina here.
Just look at Tamina go.
Did you hear the thud on that impact? Oh my god.
I wish
goodness,
we knew some money on this
one.
If we did,
like
but... I'm gonna stunner them or no bear signature.
Devastating crane limp back with that move. Super kick! Ouch! Tamina just being down.
Oh, soon! We could be seeing a submission here!
The submission is locked in deep. Bad comments on. And for some reason, she lets go of the hold. Could have just been a tease of the potential agony that's yet to come. And it's Natalya with the reversal.
Natalya finding the breathing room she needed now.
Natty was getting grinded down, but just created a chance to change things. From way up, oh, the high risk doesn't pay off. Taken to the air and completely wiping out. Natalya failing to offer any resistance here. I don't know if Natalya can withstand this.
Oops.
A jumping headbutt.
Oh, man.
Devastating kick. Oh, ooh, sharp kick.
I want to see those moves one more time. Okay.
Out of ringside and back to the mat. Oh, Tamina gets cut off.
Going counter for counter. Now, can it be capitalized on?
A non-stop assault from Tamina here.
Just look at Tamina go.
Just insulting. Oh, drop kick. Big four.
Good God, he missed low.
Look at him.
She shoots up the top rope.
Dangerous thinking. Oh. Airborne with the splash.
Exclamation delivered by Tamina.
Okay, so we have her now in the NXT points now.
Amazing resilience. Is this the start of a comeback?
But if we see one more devastating move again, this can be over soon. Answer after answer for each other's offense here.
She is kind of out of stamina. She's kind of bad. I probably shouldn't play around here.
Still up? Squatting too,
I hate
my
this
gosh.
Move so much.
Natalya knows exactly what she's doing, and it is not good for her opponent.
Stomp after stomp after stomp.
I can't believe I keep missing this.
Ooh, she just turned it around. Showing some extra scouting, knowing how to answer a counter with a counter of your own. Tamina, she's thinking big. Here we go again.
It could be over.
We have seen such a physical match from these combatants, and the wear and tear is starting to show. Now's the time where the smartest competitor needs to take advantage of the situation. Needs to figure out the quickest way to end this.
Oh, man.
Thinking she can close this one out. Stopping their tracks with a knee to the gut. Powerful contact by Tamina.
And up the turnbuckle as we go.
She is queuing it up again. Tamina goes airborne.
Let's see if that's enough.
Will that prove to be enough this time?
Alright, so that's that one out of the way. It is interesting that it looks like they're Pete Diamond.
Here's your winner.
All the,
Tamina!
a lot of emphasis on it. At least most of the defense. It's kind of interesting. With a strong victory.
She was so committed to walking out the winner.
It means those cards are actually in the game now, as far as like if you had cards hot enough, they would be showing up in Faction Wars. But so anyway, we did get the Yokozuna, and we did complete part one of the dungeon. So I've got a few more to go in this batch. Let's go look at that card. So, as you can see, this card is your basic Sapphire card. It's got decent finishers for a Sapphire, but stats are kind of, and good body durability. It does have Sting Like a Bee, which is pretty good, but it doesn't have a lot of badges. Rage is kind of whatever for me. So, it's not a card I'll use until I have to, which I guess I will for the next live event that picks all four of these. But anyway, I think that's probably going to do it for this video. We appreciate you coming out watching with us. We'll see you next time. And take care. Okay, so here we are looking at the Island vs. Dungeon Part 2 of 4 live event in WWE 2K23. So, this will be a battle between the Bloodline Flame Tree and the Heart Dynasty. It's a one-on-one match. You have to use the Solo Sokoa WrestleMania card against Umaga. And you're going to get a Umaga live event card, which will be used later on in the final live event. So, let's do it and see how this goes. Oh, we're fighting against a diamond. Jim the Anvil Neidhart. Sela seems a bit slow in his moveset. We have to get 90 MFP. So let's look and make sure.
Is this? It's time to come hungry and leave no man untested. Jim the Anvil Neidhart is here. Dominating strength, one of the greatest powerhouses in the history of this business. A multi-time champion and a WWE Hall of Famer. Grit your teeth because the Anvil packs a punch that's almost as big as his person. A true legend of the ring in action here tonight.
And then there's Solo Sokoa, a superstar who is a part of a legendary family legacy in this industry. He's a born fighter who spent his early years battling on the streets.
That's why he's known as the Street Champ. Those experiences gifted Solo with incredible toughness and a no-quit attitude. Once he sets his sights on a target, the Street Champ never backs down.
How did the last punch end up there?
Heads out of the ring. What's next? He steps foot in the ring again. Corey, we've seen Solo Sokoa get a bit hot, as it were, during matches before. He's a superstar who gets easily agitated and irritated more often than not. How do you think that's going to affect him here in this one?
I feel like I took a little
damage. Well, hopefully, he doesn't let it affect him here, Cole. The last thing Sokoa needs to do here is be a hothead and let his emotions drive him, as that could spell disaster for him.
Yeah, he's
cool, calm, and collected is the name of the game, and Sokoa would do well to remember that. Off. And will this be it? Getting the shoulder up before two.
He clearly has no intention of staying down.
Good lord. That was nasty.
He has a task at hand, but prefers to be showboating right now.
Yes, he didn't come here to watch him boast and taunt.
Pulled in from belly to belly.
Been put on the defensive.
Oh, and that buys some time. Going counter for counter. Now, can it be capitalized on?
Overhand connects. What reason?
suplexes to stop Sakala.
Brilliant countering by both competitors. Bam!
Ooh, sharp kick.
All right.
Hits him with the counter. Big knee. And right between the shoulder blades.
So, still got some NFP to get here.
The anvil firing up, feeding off the energy in this.
Yes.
Perfect time to attack when his guard is down.
Feels like I'm not hitting his head.
Solo with an emphatic statement there.
The street champ is in the building, and he's not backing down. Look at this, going counter for counter.
Piercing the throat.
He may be in a bad way here. There's been plenty of action in this match, and the cost of that is really showing now.
Oh, there we go.
Timely counter by Anvil.
Let's see if we can see this much of his resilience.
Oh, had that well scouted. Oh, right to the throat.
Ooh. Okay, that was not expected. I will take a win there.
Down on the windpipe.
Did not expect that.
And huge burning lariat.
This could do it.
So I will take a win there. Like that without a resilience. Looks like a resilience attack.
And Solo Sikoa comes up huge with the win.
Easy match.
Here is your winner, Solo Sikoa.
A statement victory by this guy tonight.
This is the product of hard work and in-ring adaptability. He's got all the tools, and he put them to use tonight.
See you, Robert Carr. Probably the only time I probably use that card is for the match if I want it. So we'll move on. So now it's time for the Island versus the Dungeon part 3 of 4. This is one uses the gold Jimmy Uso from the Danger Zone packs. This is for the Sapphire Rikishi. This is a one-on-one match against the Diamond British Bulldog, I believe. So let's go get it done. Not use this Jimmy Uso card. Before we start, I just want to look at just a couple of things here. So his finisher is from the top rope.
Jimmy Uso is loyal. He is completely unwavering in his dedication to his family.
Let's just start punching him a bit here. Make sure we stun him first.
Just as bad as his bark. Actually, his bite might be significantly worse than his bark.
Yeah, there's no room for messing around when you're dealing with the British Bulldog. His pure wrestling talent is enough to give even seasoned opponents doubts about their chances.
Well, that is a sign that definitely gets the point across.
Dodge right off cue.
This card does have some fairly fast wide attacks, which is something I do like. That was a lot of damage just for one hit. I guess it's a gold versus a diamond, isn't it? That's how that works.
See being exploited here in this one.
We know Jimmy loves to get the pace going, loves to get high octane. We also know just how much that can lead to crashing and burning. So you need to play it smart. Pick your spots so Jimmy crashes and burns right where you want him.
No respect at all.
It can also be meant to antagonize. Could be a method of luring your opponent into a mistake.
Countered it. I probably should have went for the stun, but it does take a while for him to stun because he doesn't have this thing like a B or anything. So.
Wasting no time getting his shoulder up. Not yet.
I don't know if they're going to have any taste buds left after that.
Kick to the body.
Well, let's build him up again here.
Beautiful shot block.
And Davey Boy can't stop.
He thinks he has it.
A kick out before the referee can get to one.
He is definitely struggling to keep him down at this point.
There's a special word that I can't say on air for that type of slap.
Hey, keep things T for team, Corey.
Oh, kick connects.
Popped up.
Jimmy Uso with a Samoan drop.
Jimmy Uso is pushing himself beyond his limits. This is going to pay dip. Top row. Uso splash.
I didn't get the pin in there. Yep, figured that would happen. That's okay.
Just look at Jimmy gain the momentum in this one.
Jimmy displaying a lot of intensity.
Monkey flip.
That had some hype to it, didn't it?
British perfect time to attack. His guard is down.
that heavy combo was just. Out of stamina, so let's kind of walk away for a second and gain some of that back.
All right, that's it. Huh. Reversal! Can he take advantage? And Jimmy able to reverse that. Rip into the corner.
Corner shotgun drop kick.
I'll tell you, this guy's no competitor here. He's looking to give in. It's going to take a lot to end this fight.
We are just seeing sheer perseverance. Nothing is being left.
See if we can do this finisher right now.
Jimmy Uso splash. Jimmy might have just finished things.
Rope break. No, no. I don't think he was that close to the rope, but. Stamina is gone again.
It's up there that he should have to handle.
So we'll let him roll out of the ring there and gain a little bit of stamina. Let's see those moves one more time. Okay. Okay, let's do this again. I'll try it again anyway.
Catches a punch.
Punch lands. Solid punch. Jimmy Uso stomping away in the corner.
Ooh.
It's Uso time.
Boom. Got hurt.
Headed to the top rope.
Uso.
Uso splash.
Okay, shouldn't be a rope break this time. All right, and that's got it. So,
here is your winner, Jimmy Uso. He definitely got the job done tonight.
Jimmy Uso showed why he has the entire WWE locker room on lockdown.
Alright, so got that done. Should get the Rikishi card now. And there's the Rikishi card. So that has that done until part four. So now it's time for the Dylan versus the Dungeon part 404 live event. This is the last of the preliminary events. The final will be out shortly using all four of the cards that are received from the first four parts. This one is a one-on-one match against, looks like, Bret the Hitman Hart. using gold Danger Zone Jey Uso. So let's get started. And there we go. So I'm not used this card, so when we get into the match, we're going to look at his moveset just to make sure that we're, you know, doing everything the way it needs to be, because I believe this is against a diamond. Yes, diamond Bret the Hitman Hart. So let's see movesets. So he does have a standing in his finisher diving, so I mean, 60 MFP points. And that was a swing and a miss. His... his moveset's a little... takes a little bit of being used to. He's stunned, so let's get some of our taunts in here. He came out of that really quick. That's okay. That just, focus on Jey at all times. Jey is fast. That locked heavy combo just really pushes him back, doesn't it? That, how far he goes. Makes it kind of an awkward combo. Jumped over his head. So far, I've done a pretty good job of countering. I don't really have. Well, there's our 60 MFP, so... let's get him outside of the ring so we can get some of our stamina back. Seems to be just getting up really fast. And so far I've got the finisher and my signature countered, so...
Jey puts a stop to that.
Oh. Really? Can you go up the ropes there? And we got the resiliency, so I should only get some moves one more time. I figured I'd try it.
That can be very costly. Don't know if the risk was worth it.
And returning to the ring.
Looks like I can just finish it here, but I don't know.
The colossal clutch! The colossal clutch! And you imagine what it would do to his confidence if he tapped out right here, right now? And he may have felt his grip slipping, so he releases the hold.
Still was able to produce some considerable damage, though.
And proving a bit slippery for him there.
And one more reversal. Talk about evenly matched here.
Could be the beginning of the end.
Sharpshooter reply.
Sharpshooter's locked in. Hart is cranking it with everything he's got.
I'm just afraid I'm gonna miss that, so we'll just pop a resiliency here as much as I hate to.
Spin kick to the midsection. Punch right to the face. Sharp punch. Look at Jay.
Okay, should we try this finisher one more time? And that's it. I think that should give us our Roman Reigns card, which is the last of the four cards for this live event campaign, so to speak.
And he certainly proved himself a superstar to watch with this one.
It looks like Brett's opponent was even better than the best there ever will be.
And there's our Roman Reigns. So now we move to the finale. Alright, and so we move on to the decisive battle, the Island versus the Dungeon, which is the final battle in this long live event. This is for Amethyst Celesticoa 89. It's an 8-man tag elimination, so it is typically going to be a long battle. Because you have to eliminate each one of them, and you know, you've got Sapphire cards going against Pink Diamonds. So, you know, it just means that it takes more damage to be able to get those cards out. Which just means the match takes longer. So
pick up the ball and win the match by themselves. He's taking a moment to feel the crowd, but he better focus on the opposition.
They kind of seem like the Pink Diamonds come out of the stuns quicker too, because with a full stun like that, I should have been able to get both taunts off. I guess I did, because it did give me credit for it, but I should not have been hit in a normal match, you know, that we're used to.
Presence felt. That's when a competitor needs to utilize the anything goes tip
manipulation to their benefit and eliminate the mismatch.
Getting him into the corner. Caught him right in the jaw.
What a shot.
You notice we did not get the resiliency there. Typically, with that long of a... submission, you would see a resiliency. After having that much damage to him, you'd usually see resiliency with a submission that lasts that long, if I'm trying to say. But, you know, just in Pink Diamond, it takes a little bit more, I guess. I don't know. Because there's not a whole lot more that you could take off in Nightheart back then. He's pretty low. It takes so long for him to wind up that move. I don't know why. See, that's so annoying that they punch the guy and you're the one that's done lower than he is because you're sitting there shaking your head. That's ridiculous right there. I'm sorry. It's interesting about these matches. I don't know if it's something to do with the new patch, but when they pick up a chair outside the ring, they just stand there with it. It's really weird. Like, in one of the earlier matches of this, one of mine did the same thing. He just stood there with that chair. I just wonder if he had a hold of the chair, would he just sit in there till they counted him out? I don't know who the legal man is. That's Brett. Okay. See, those punches just go right through him. Okay, we'll stun those.
I don't think anyone inside this building was expecting a kick out after that move from Yokozuna.
Alright. We're gonna switch him out here. Oh, wow. That was not at all what I was trying to do. See, the punches go through them sometimes, which is weird. This will probably be resiliency. Stop.
Roman has been denied. This is not something we're used to seeing, and by the looks of things, now time on the island of relevancy. Our body is not meant to bend that way. The love of God submit.
Oh, wow. It's like you swing the wrong way. I'm not sure why it does that sometimes. Come on, ref, do something. I'm not even sure if I remember what his Alright. I got it. It's been kind of a long night with this one. It is entertaining though, just using cards you probably would never use, and or a different kind of play style than what you're used to. So. Hopefully the card. And there's our solo Sikoa. So alright, let's go look at the card real quick. Oop, not the Week of the Towers. Events. Alright, so you got really good running offense, decent arm power, good durability, good finisher. Submissions are a little lacking, but he does have gold sting like a bee, gold heavy handed, and gold merciless opportunist. also Pain Train and starting the match with some special. So this is a really good looking card. So we'll see how it plays here soon. So anyway, we're gonna end the video there. So appreciate you joining us, and we'll see you next time.